A very good morning, friends. Today we will discuss about an important amino acid, that is tryptophan. It is a essential amino acids. Remember that in 10 essential amino acid, the mnemonic is mat will fly. In this mat will fly, there are two T. One is for threonine and another is for tryptophan. There is no tyrosine in essential amino acid. Now in the metabolism of tryptophan, in the major pathway which occurs in the liver, this tryptophan will give glucose and fat. There is formation of alanine and acetoacetyl coenzyme A. The alanine will give the glucose and acetoacetyl coenzyme A will give the fat. In the specialized product given by the tryptophan, it gives NAD and NADP. Then it gives serotonin, it gives melatonin, and this is a excretory product, that is hydroxyindoleacetic acid. So these are the compounds which are given by the tryptophan in the metabolic fate, and it also incorporates into the protein during the protein synthesis. In the major pathway, tryptophan will give you glucose and fat, while in the minor pathway or in the minor percentage, it will give NAD, NADP, serotonin, melatonin, and it is excreted as hydroxyindoleacetic acid. Now coming to the metabolism of tryptophan proper, it follows two important pathways. The first one is the kynurenine-anthranilate pathway. The first pathway is kynurenine-anthranilate pathway. In this pathway, these are the intermediate, kynurenine and anthranilate, these are the intermediates. That's why it is known as kynurenine-anthranilate pathway. And through this pathway, there is formation of glucose, there is formation of fat, and there is synthesis of NAD and NADP. This pathway occurs in the liver, and the starting enzyme for this pathway is the tryptophan pyrolase. So through this pathway, this tryptophan, it is converted into, this pathway is known as kynurenine-anthranilate pathway. So intermediates are kynurenine and anthranilate. If you don't remember the pathway, write down the tryptophan. After that tryptophan, write down the kynurenine. Then write down the anthranilate, and through the multiple steps, it will give you NAD and NADP. Okay, now we'll see the pathway. By the action of tryptophan pyrolase, this tryptophan is converted into N-formyl kynurenine. This N-formyl kynurenine is converted into kynurenine. Then by the action of hydroxylase, it is converted into 3-hydroxy kynurenine. With the help of kynureninase, it is converted into 3-hydroxyanthranilate, which is converted into unstable compound, that is 2-amino-3-carboxy muconate semialdehyde. We will see the enzyme. This is by the tryptophan pyrolase. It is a iron metalloprotein. It is a iron metalloprotein, contain iron. Molecular oxygen is incorporated in the indole ring, causes cleavage of the indole ring and converts this tryptophan into N-formyl kynurenine. Then second enzyme is the formamidase. The another name is kynurenine formylase with the removal of formate, which is important in the one carbon metabolism. There is synthesis of kynurenine. Now with the help of kynureninase, hydroxylase this is NADPH dependent reaction, and with the help of kynurenine hydroxylase there is synthesis of 3-hydroxy kynurenine, and with the help of kynureninase, which is PLP dependent, pyridoxal phosphate dependent enzyme, causes conversion of kynurenine into anthranilate. And if there is blockade in this reaction, or if there is deficiency of vitamin B6, the active form is pyridoxal phosphate, this kynurenine, 3-hydroxykynurenine, is diverted for the xanthurenate excretion in urine. In the deficiency of vitamin B6. Now this 3-hydroxy anthranilate by the oxidase is converted into unstable intermediate, that is 2-amino-3-carboxymeconate-semialdehyde. Now this compound has 3 fate. 2-amino-3-carboxymeconate-semialdehyde, it has 3 fate. In the first reaction, by the carboxylase, it gives the picolinate. By the removal of CO2, it gives by the picolinate carboxylase. This is 2-amino-3-carboxymeconate-semialdehyde. Okay. Now this compound on carboxylase reaction, by the removal of CO2, it will give picolinate. And on spontaneous reaction, it will give quinolinate. And by the decarboxylase, again by the removal of CO2, decarboxylase, it gives the 2-amino-muconate-semialdehyde, and this through multiple steps will give acetoacetyl-CoA, which will give fat. So this is the generation of fat here. There is synthesis of alanine in this reaction. And this alanine will ultimately converted into glucose. So this is how glucose and fat generated from the tryptophan. One is here and another one is from the alanine. Now this quinolinate reaction, this quinolinate is converted into nicotinamide mononucleotide. This nicotinamide mononucleotide is converted into nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, which is converted into nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. So this is the major pathway known as kynurenine anthranilate pathway. In this pathway, tryptophan is converted into N-formyl kynurenine by the tryptophan pyrolase. This, with the removal of formate, it is converted into kynurenine. By the hydroxylation process, this kynurenine is converted into 3-hydroxykynurenine, which with the help of PLP dependent kynureninase will give the alanine and 3-hydroxyanthranilate. And 3-hydroxyanthranilate on oxidase reaction, it gives 2-amino-3-carboxymeconate-semialdehyde, which is an unstable intermediate. It has 3 fate. It will give picolinate. On spontaneous reaction, it gives quinolinate. And through the decarboxylase reaction, it will give the two amino muconate semialdehyde, which ultimately gives the acetoacetyl-CoA, which will give the fat. This is the spontaneous reaction, and it is quinolinate, then acted upon by quinolinate phosphoribosyl transferase. It will give mononucleotide, which is converted into dinucleotide, which is converted into dinucleotide phosphate. So there is generation of alanine here. This is the first. Then there is generation of acetoacetyl-CoA, which gives the fat, second. Then there is formation of NAD and NADP. Now we'll discuss the serotonin pathway. This is the kynurenine anthranilate pathway. In the serotonin pathway, we can compare this serotonin pathway with the synthesis of epinephrine and norepinephrine. It is the simple one, and the reactions are exactly similar. Only one difference is there. Exactly similar to that of the norepinephrine and epinephrine synthesis. Okay. Now what happens in this reaction? The first reaction, tryptophan, it is converted into 5-hydroxytryptophan. This is tetrahydrobiopterin dependent reaction. And in this reaction, tetrahydrobiopterin is converted into dihydrobiopterin, and which is again regenerated with the help of NADPH dependent dihydrobiopterin reductase. This reaction is similar to that of the phenylalanine hydroxylase reaction. And the enzyme for this reaction is tryptophan hydroxylase. So the enzyme is tryptophan hydroxylase. Now, in the second reaction, this 5-hydroxytryptophan is converted into 5-hydroxytryptamine. The another name for 5-hydroxytryptamine is the serotonin. The another name is serotonin. This is with the help of decarboxylase reaction. Here is removal of CO2, and this is the decarboxylase reaction. Then with the help of acetylase, there is addition of acetyl-CoA, coenzyme A, and with the help of acetylase, it is converted into N-acetyl-serotonin. This N-acetyl-serotonin accepts methyl group from S-adenosyl-methionine. This is the methyl transferase reaction. And in this reaction, it is converted into melatonin. So this is methyl transferase reaction. In this reaction, the S-adenosylmethionine is act as a methyl donor. So this is this. You can compare this pathway to the norepinephrine and epinephrine synthesis. So there is synthesis of serotonin here and melatonin. Then this serotonin, it is converted into, serotonin is 5-hydroxytryptamine. This, with the help of monoamine oxidase, this serotonin is converted into hydroxyindole acetic acid, which is excreted in the urine. So these are the products given by the tryptophan. First, through the kynurenine anthranilate pathway, it will give the alanine, which will give the glucose. Then it will give the acetoacetyl coenzyme A, which will ultimately convert it into fat. Then it gives the NAD and NADP through this pathway. Then via the serotonin pathway, it gives serotonin, melatonin, and there is formation of hydroxyindole acetic acid, which is excreted in the urine. Apart from that, tryptophan is incorporated into a protein and helps in the protein synthesis. There are three important disorders related to the tryptophan. First one is the Hartnup's disease. This disease is due to the defective absorption of tryptophan. It is due to the defect in absorption of tryptophan from intestine and renal tubule. Intestine and renal tubule. So this will lead to the pellagra like symptoms, because this 60 milligram of tryptophan will give 1 milligram of niacin. It is responsible for formation of NAD and NADP. So 60 milligram will give 1 milligram of niacin. As there is defective absorption of tryptophan, it leads to the pellagra like symptoms. So this is the first disease, that is heart nerves disease. Coming to the second important disease, that is argentaphinoma or carcinoid tumor. The another name is argentaphinoma. There is synthesis of serotonin in the brain, mast cell, platelet and intestine. So it is in intestine, it is produced by the argentaphin cells. And when there is tumor of argentaphin cell, near about 60% of tryptophan is diverted to the serotonin production. That is known as carcinoid tumor, carcinoid syndrome or argentaphinoma. Normal synthesis of serotonin occurs in this tissue, brain, mast cell, platelet and intestine. The major pathway, that is it is degradation into glucose and fat, that occurs in the liver. Coming to the third, that is xanthourinate excretion in urine. In B6 deficiency, there is excretion of xanthourinate in urine occurs, because the kynurenine is defective and it is diverted for the production of xanthourinate and it gets excreted in urine. So there is generation of NAD and NADP via the tryptophan. Then serotonin and melatonin. The serotonin, it is responsible for maintenance or regulation of blood pressure. It is responsible for temperature regulation. Then it is cerebral excitator or excitatory neurotransmitter. So these are the two important functions of serotonin. Melatonin is responsible for the sleep and wake cycle, and it is synthesized by the pineal gland of the body in response to the light. It decreases the production of melanocyte stimulating hormone, also decreases the ACTH production. So this is all about the melatonin. So summarizing the all, tryptophan in its metabolism will give the glucose and fat in the major pathway in the liver. Then it will give the NAD and NADP, that is 60 milligram of tryptophan will give the 1 milligram of niacin. Then through the serotonin pathway, it will give serotonin and melatonin, and it is excreted at hydroxyindole acetic acid, catalyzed by the monoamine oxidase. So this is all about tryptophan metabolism. Keep watching. Thank you.